tossing and turning. Sleep just won't come. You hate to see the sunrise on another day, and you dread the sorrow that waits for tomorrow. You're out of hope, but thank God for grace.
When there's no hope,
praise God, everybody. This is yours truly, the evangelist, Willie Grizzle. Praise God. We got Brother Steve, the pastor. Amen. Pastor Steve Bailey in the chat room and in the studio in the ministry today. Hey, man, we trying to be faithful that Brother Steve will come every other Wednesday that I'm off, that he'll come and join us to bring the word to a lost and dying nation. Amen. Praise God. You know, it's been faithful, Brother Steve, every Wednesday that I've been off, that he be able to come in and bring the word and just lift the Lord Jesus Christ, his name, up on high. Praise God. But, you know, a lot of people today, they pick and choose when to serve God. Amen. Let me tell you something. That day, one of these days, we'll all stand before judgment. And there won't be no excuses. Amen. You know, a lot of people think, well, I'll just go to church on Sunday or go to church on Wednesday or Tuesday, whenever we go to church. That's all God requires of me. Well, let me tell you something. If you're born again, washed in the blood of Jesus Christ, brothers and sisters, he requires a lot from you. I mean, every minute, every second, every moment of your life, that you see somebody that's brokenhearted, somebody that's hurting, somebody that needs the passion of the grace of glory upon their life, they need to get up and get live. Because, you know, one day we're going to have to answer. See, as an evangelist, as a pastor, Brother Steve, you know, one thing we got to understand that we're going to be double judged for the things we do in this walk of life. So, brothers and sisters, let's calm down here for a minute, amen, and let's go to prayer, amen. Lord, our Heavenly Father, we come before you, mighty God. We ask you to watch over us and give us strength for the words to say today, Lord. We ask you, mighty God, that your will be done in heaven be on earth, Lord. We ask you, mighty God, to watch over us and give us strength and to be in your will. Lord, we ask you to cast your spirit of gloriness around us, Lord. Lord, we ask you to give us strength and knowledge and let your will be done. Let not these words that we speak of today, dear Lord, go out void, Lord. We ask you to cover their souls and their minds today, Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen and amen. Praise God. Praise God. You know, I don't know about you, Brother Steve, but I feel the glory of the Lord all around me. Amen. Praise God. And I hope today, live or archived, that you, if you got a prayer request today that you need an answer, amen. Let's all come to one mind, one accord, and pray. Amen. Praise God. So, brothers and sisters, let's grab another song here. The name of the song, praise God, is Hold Me When I Cry. Amen. You know, there's times in our lives that we don't know what we're going to do, and we're just shut down. Amen. And we don't know where to turn to or who's going to be there on the very end. But let me tell you something. There's one person that we can guarantee that's going to be there at the end. And that's Jesus Christ. Praise God. So, brothers and sisters, enjoy this song here, Hold Me When I Cry.
It's been one of those days. If anything could go wrong, it went wrong. I know I'm feeling sorry for me. There's a lot of self-pity going on. Tomorrow I will be okay. The dawn will bring a brand new day. I'm sure by then I'll be fine. Lord, today I really need a friend. I know that you understand. Would you hold me while I cry? I take a lot of your time when I should be strong. I should be standing by now, but it's you I'm leaving. You've always kept me safe from harm, like a child in your arms. You've cradled me through hardships faced in life. Lord, it's just one of those days. I've been fought in every way. Would you hold me while I cry? I try to be strong, but if anyone can fall apart, I'll fall apart. I run back to you again, and you heal my broken heart. You have truly been a friend, reaching out to you could have passed me by. I'm asking for your strength today. Lift my spirit, Lord, I pray. Will you just hold me while I cry? I take a lot of your time when I should be strong. You, I'm leaning on.
Praise God. You know, there's so many times in our life, Brother Steve, I don't know about you, that it feels like the whole world's against us. But you know, Jesus said he would never leave us and never forsake us. Amen. You know how powerful God we have. Amen. So, brothers and sisters, we're going to kick on the ministry mic. And amen. We're going to introduce Brother Steve. Pastor Steve Bailey into the chat, into the ministry. I got my mind on the chat room for some reason, but you know, it's all good. We all, we're here for one reason only, is to win souls, breaking broken hearts, amen, and just let God be God.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. So, brothers and sisters, let me open her wide open on page, amen, to Brother Steve. So, Brother Steve, how you doing today?
Oh, I'm doing fairly well.
Praise God. Praise God. So, the mic is yours, my brother.
Good afternoon out there in Radio Land. I'll tell you what, it's a cold, blustery day out there, but the Lord knows what he's doing. And if we'll put our trust in him, there'll be nothing that'll go wrong.
Amen.
People, I'd like to go to the third chapter of James this afternoon. It's a subject that's been talked about many times. But I'll assure you, the Lord laid it upon me to bring it to you one more time.
Amen.
So all that have Bibles and like to keep up with me, it'll be in the third chapter of James.
Amen.
Starting at verse number 1. My brethren, be ye not many masters, knowing that we shall receive the greater condemnation.
Amen.
For in many things we offend all. If any man offend not in word, the same is a perfect man, and able to also bridle the whole body. People, I'll tell you what, he's talking about bridling the body there. People, there's no way we could bridle the body. Only Jesus Christ can bridle the body down.
Amen, come on.
People, I'll tell you what, it's talking about the tongue and a few little verses on down. People, there's ways. People have tried their best during this age and ages past to bridle their tongue. There's no way the tongue will be bridled except through Jesus Christ.
Amen.
People that old farmers of old had put bits in horses' mouths to guide them with.
Praise God.
People, I'll tell you what, sometimes I wonder if they don't have to have a set of bits in a man's mouth to guide him.
Hey, man, come on, life. Bring it, bro, bring it.
People, I'll tell you what, it's time. It's time we learn what to use that tongue for. We don't use that tongue to doubt our human man when we use it to upbuild him with.
Amen.
It's time, people, we use our tongue to glorify God with instead of using it to compliment the president or the vice one. Just use it to just uplift God with.
Amen.
People, that's what we're here today for, is to praise the Lord. We're not here no one for no other reason. Brother Willie, if I was here for another reason, I just might as well walk out the door.
Amen.
I'll tell you what, right now, I feel like running out.
Woo, come on.
But I'm going to tell you what, that tongue is a mighty powerful thing. It can bring you up or it can let you down.
Amen.
The third chapter of James speaks on the tongue.
Amen.
People, it's time we used our tongues for something besides doubting our fellow man.
Amen.
People, I'll tell you what. On the same accord, goes for respecter of person. You can't be a respecter of person. God's not a respecter of person, neither should you be.
That's right.
People will use their tongue to be respecters of person. It's time that we as children of God quit using our tongues to down our fellow man and uplift him. People, I'll tell you what, the big ship out there on the water, they use a thing called a rudder to guide them with.
That's right.
People of the Holy Spirit here to guide us. But I'm going to tell you what, if you don't follow God and the Holy Spirit, you're not going to make it.
That's right.
People, it's time we stood a little bit more for God and what He's got for us.
Amen.
People, I'll tell you what, behold, also the ships, which though they be of great, be so great, they are driven of a fierce winds. Yet are they turned about with a very small helm, whithersoever the governor listeth. People, your ship will listeth, and it'll rock down life's way. But there's a lighthouse there that guides you away from the shoals and the rocks of life.
Amen.
People, I tell you what, even so the tongue is a little member and boasteth great things. Behold, how great a matter a little fire kindleth. And the tongue is a fire, a world of iniquity. So is the tongue among members, that it defileth the whole body and setteth on fire the course of nature. And it is set on fire of hell. People, I'll tell you what, your tongue can carry you to hell too, just the same thing as anything else can.
Come on, bring it.
People, I'll tell you what, that tongue is a poison little thing. It's like a snake crawling on the ground.
Amen.
People, we got to learn when to use our tongue and how to use our tongue.
Come on.
People, I'll tell you what, as the Holy Spirit speaks to you this afternoon, and as the Word speaks to you, just take it to heart this afternoon. God's telling you how to use your tongue and what to use it for. People, I'll tell you what. For every kind of beast and bird and serpents and of the things in the sea is tame, hath been tamed by mankind. We've tamed birds. We've tamed dogs. We've tamed cats.
Amen.
But we've been able to tame our tongue. People, ain't but one way to tame that tongue down, and that's through the blood of Jesus Christ.
That's right.
The only way you can tame it down.
Whoop,
people, I'll tell you what, I feel good this afternoon. But I'll tell you what, there ain't but one way that you're going to make it there and make it home, and that's through the blood.
That's right.
People, I'll tell you, next time we use this old tongue for something besides down in our fellow man, we got to get a little dose of God. Well, we can talk by Him. We got to get it in our minds where we can think by Him. Brother Willie, we got to get Him in our feet where we can walk by Him. We got to get Him in our feet where we can run by Him.
Amen.
Sometimes, people, I feel like just running out the door. But I'm going to tell you what, it's time we use our tongues for something beside that downfall.
Amen.
Well, thank you, Lord. People, I'll tell you what, that is the same way goes respect a person. You can't be a respect a person and love God, because God's not a respecter of person.
That's right. Come on.
People, I'll tell you what, there's a lot of people who go to churches nowadays, they look on for their fine clothes. I ask the question, what are we here for? Worship clothes or worship God?
That's right. Come on.
People, I'll tell you what, it's time we quit worshiping clothes and go to worshiping God, the one that gives us the clothes.
That's right.
People, I'll tell you what, just listen to what the Holy Ghost has to say to you this afternoon. People, I'll tell you what, we're trying to come from the third and the second chapter of James here, but I'm going to tell you what, the Lord knows the reason it's coming from both ways. He wants us to remind ourselves not to be a respecter of person and how to use our tongue. People, when we get the idea of how to use that tongue, then we can glorify Him better.
That's right.
Oh, thank you, Lord. But the tongue can no man tame. It's unruly, evil, and full of deadly poison. That deadly poison, people, he's talking about there, is what you say about your fellow man. That's what you say to your fellow man. People, there's a lot of people that go to church nowadays, they go to church, worship God, and then come out of cussing and raring.
That's right.
Some of them go to the line and get about half loaded drunk. People, this is not the life of God. This is the life of the devil.
That's right.
People, I'll tell you what, when they get the true baptism of the Holy Spirit,
amen,
then they won't touch that old alcohol. Then they won't use bad language. Then they won't talk about their fellow man like a dog. People, it's time we got off the bench and got in the game.
Amen.
Brother Willie, I'll tell you what. I hate to be so hard and harsh this afternoon. Amen. But that's the way the Lord give it to me.
That's right.
That's the way I'm going to tell about it.
Don't sugarcoat it.
People, I'll tell you what. A man with a sugar-coated tongue ain't worth nothing.
That's right.
And I've said it time and time again. I want my sugar in my coffee. I don't want them ears.
Amen. Come on.
People, it's time to remove that sweet stuff out of your ears and listen to something that'll burn them once in a while.
Amen.
It's time to listen to something that'll burn our feet. People, we don't aim for the feet, we aim for the heart. And I'm going to tell you what, it's time we open our hearts. It's time we open our minds. And it's time we got out of business with God.
That's right.
People, I'll tell you what. When the use of that tongue, you got to learn God's going to bridle it for you. If you let Him bridle your tongue, then He can bridle the whole body and make it what He has it to be. People, that's all the Lord gave me to say this afternoon. But God bless you. Be my prayer.
Amen.
Sign off.
Praise the Lord. Woo! What a powerful word. Praise God. What a powerful word. You know, Brother Steve, I'm sitting here and I was just looking over that James 3, second verse. Amen. Where it says here, For in many things we offer all, and any man offer not in word, the same as a perfect man, and able to bridle the whole body.
Yeah.
Praise God. But you know, a lot of people thinks that you just, when you go to church, that you just got to bounce up and jump up and sing and spit on your head and all that good stuff. Sometimes you just got to go to listen. Amen.
Yeah.
Sometimes you just got to have a shoulder somebody to cry on. Sometimes you just got to get up and obey God.
Yep.
Now, a lot of people, I don't know about you, Brother Steve, but I know you've probably been to a lot of churches that you walk into a church, it's like an icebox.
Amen.
You're looking around to see if you can find tombstones, because there's a lot of dead folks in churches today. Amen? Praise God. But you know, if you can be perfect in the Word of God, we both to be able to walk down the street, and if we see a blind man, our shadow is both to heal him. If body of Christ be in our hearts, we both to be out and about doing the Father's business. But you know, there ain't much of that going on now.
Right.
Invite them to come to our church and you'll see a miracle happen. Let me tell you something. How about the church? The walking, talking, breathing, fire stomping. Walk out there and serve God. This is the problem with the church today. They don't want to get out of their comfort zone. They want to stand up and say, well, come on to my church. We'll have a good dinner, and you bring a little this, you bring a little that, and you'll see a great miracle worker. Let me tell you something. You want to see a miracle worker, put legs on your prayers, amen? Get out there and obey God. I know that's your wife, she's in the nursing home, but you praying and praying every day that she's going to come back, amen, and live with you, and get up and do the Father's business. See, what you're doing is you're putting feet under your prayers.
Amen.
See, you ain't letting the roof stop your prayers.
Amen.
Because you're going to continue on to God.
Amen.
Does what He's promised He'd do.
Amen.
He said He'd never leave you. He'd never forsake you, brothers and sisters. You know, we need to get up and tell the world today, if you're not serving God, you're serving the devil. Because the world is going to fall down one day. This whole world is going to burn. But a lot of people don't want to believe that. Oh, no. Now, we got another 100 years. We got another 200 years. Oh, let me tell you something. We're not promised the next moment.
Well,
we can lose our lives. Somebody's leaving this earth today.
Amen.
That needs Jesus. Amen. That is falling into judgment right now. And God is telling them, He says, I never knew you.
Amen.
See, brothers and sisters, we don't get up on here every day and just be doing it for ourselves, because we are men and women, children of God.
Amen.
And if we are disobedient children, He's going to whip us like a disobedient child. You know, I got a little girl, praise the Lord, she's 13 years old. I've only had to whoop her twice. Amen. But you know, I didn't make idle threats. I told her once, and then I showed her the consequences. Praise God. You know, brothers and sisters, we need to always be obeying God. Amen. You know, we got a testimony from Brother Boyd here. Praise God. Wait a minute here. We got a call in. Amen. From Brother
Let's see, who is it from? Praise God. Where'd you go? Carnage, Tennessee. Amen. It's a 1 minute call. So, brothers and sisters, let's listen in to this. Praise God. I've got a new caller. Amen. So, here we go.
Hey, this is Brother Irvin Taylor. I just want to say I thank God for everything he's done for me and everything he's going to do for me. Amen. We just need to praise him in the bad times as well in the good times. Seems like when we're up on top of the mountain, we just forget to praise him. But when we're down in the valley, struggling, that's when we really want to praise him.
Amen.
And then we need to praise him at all times. Amen. We need to realize that God made this earth and God made it. And amen, he's going to be the one to destroy it. Whether you're ready or not, he's coming.
Amen.
And he's coming back again. And we better be ready. And then wrinkle, spot, and blemish just ain't going to go. He wants
amen.
Perfect. He wants a perfect body. And amen, if you ain't ready to go, get ready to go.
Amen.
I love y'all. God bless.
Woo! Brother Everett Taylor. Thank you, brother, for calling in and obeying God. And how's that's about the subject we're talking about today, ain't it, Brother Steve?
Amen.
That, a lot of people today thinks they can do what they want and think they're going to get into heaven. Does not the word says that he's coming back for a bride that is unblemished?
Amen.
He ain't coming back for no heart.
Amen.
And he ain't going to have to, he ain't going to sit around and wait for you to get right. See, brothers and sisters, today is the day of salvation. It's time for you. Amen. See, we're ready to go. I don't know about you, Brother Steve, but if the Lord calls my number, I ain't going to ask when. I'm gone. Amen. Praise God. You know, we need to understand where we stand with God today. A lot of people think, well, I give $50 to the church. I pay my tithes to the church, and I'm going to heaven. Let me tell you something. If you're not putting your works to faith and your faith to works, you better be stepping up.
Amen.
See, brothers and sisters, time is drawing near, brothers and sisters. You know, there's a lot of families today, amen. You know, the Bible said this is going to happen. The brothers against sisters, fathers against sons.
Amen.
And, you know, there's a lot of that trouble going on in the world today. Well, but everybody says, oh, why has this happened? God said it was going to happen.
Amen.
This is no surprise. Amen. See, the Word of God is fulfilling itself now.
Amen.
And a lot of people think, well, they've been preaching about this for years. Well, that don't make it any more or less true. Amen. Because the Word of God is the Word of God. Amen. Because when it comes to pass, it's come to pass.
Amen.
There ain't going to be no replay. When the Lord calls His bride out, brothers and sisters,
Amen.
It is time to go. Praise
Amen.
God. So, brothers and sisters, I got a brother, Bishop Eddie Chaney had, praise God, had given me a copy of Brother Urban's new CD, praise God. So, brothers and sisters, enjoy this song off of his album. Praise God. Enjoy this song. Amen. Amen.
I'm here just by the wounded soldier in the The enemy's raging around. He's crowding my mind. Lord, I'm calling out to you. Boy, you know what I need. While I'm facing this battle, send a refuge for me.
Send me down.
send a refuge for me. God, send me a
refuge to hide from the storm. Wrap me in your sweet love. Keep me safe from all. A refuge for me. Won't you hear my prayer? Send a refuge for me.
One of the songs from Brother Irvin Taylor's new album, Amen. He's in the chat room, brothers and sisters. You can hit him up on up there on Facebook on Irvin Taylor and Compassion of Love, the ministries. Amen. Praise God. The brother Bishop Eddie had sent me an album, and I still want that CD, brother. Amen. I know you're in the chat room. I see you. Amen. Praise God. So, brothers and sisters, we're just going to obey God right now. This is Brother Steve, what do you think about the situations about this world right now?
Well, the situation of the world is pathetic.
Amen.
People have actually turned their backs on God. And it's time they turned their face toward Him.
Amen.
Instead of their backs away from Him. Because we see in the Word, and He's told us time and time again to be you watching and praying.
That's right.
And some of us, and some of the churches now have turned their backs on Him. People, I don't see how much longer this world's going to make it.
That's right.
But through the help of Jesus Christ, it can make it if it'll just turn back to Him. Amen. And listen to what He's got to say.
Yeah. I think the Bible says the scripture is, if my people would turn back, man, He would heal the land, wouldn't He? Mm-hmm. You know?
My people, which are called by my name.
That's right.
Would seek my face. And I would hear from heaven and heal their land.
That's right. And we need a healer in this land.
Amen.
It's so much abomination going on. Men marrying men, women marrying women. We got... And, you know, we got people dressing up as women and whether as men. I mean, the brothers and sisters, I'm not talking about your dress code. I'm not talking about what you wear, what you do. What I'm talking is about that soul. Amen?
Amen.
That soul is what the men and women and children of God are after. Amen. We want to be gathered all together into heaven. Amen.
Amen.
We're not here to be in a political arena, because Jesus never was in a political arena. He never ran for president. He didn't run for Congress. He ran for the Heavenly Father.
Amen.
See, he will come in the flesh. Amen. And He walked with us. He teached us. He loved us. But you know, a lot of people wants just to be on that love side of God. Let me tell you something. If you're on the back side of God, then guess what happens? You're going to burn in hell.
Amen.
You know, a lot of people, I got to criticize. I got the email with Willie. You preaching about hell a lot. And I said, well, the one place I don't want to go.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. You know, a lot of people think, well, when you die, that's just it. I mean, you're off into Neverland. Lord, let me tell you something. There's two choices you can make today. You can go to heaven or you can go to hell.
Amen.
Praise God. You can go up or you can go down.
Amen.
You know, I always hear somebody, well, I come in this world with nothing, and I'm leaving with nothing. Let me tell you something. I come in the world with nothing, but I'm leaving with Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. I'm taking something. That's the Word of God.
Amen.
I ain't talking about a Bible either. I'm talking about what's been applied to my heart.
Amen.
You know, pieces of paper will burn, but let me tell you something. The Word of God will never will. Amen.
Amen.
Everybody says, well, when I get buried, I'm going to put a Bible. Let me tell you something. You won't need a Bible. If you're right with God, you won't need the Bible because there's going to be the gospel every day in heaven. Amen. Praise God. You know, a lot of people think, well, my mama went to church. My daddy went to church. And we all got saved at the same time. Let me tell you something. I'm going to make a lot of people mad right here. I don't believe in coattail salvation. I believe that you must have a personal walk with Jesus Christ.
Man.
Yourself, not a group thing. Amen. That you get up in the morning, you got to understand who is the boss. Amen. See, you couldn't get up this morning, could you, Brother Steve, if it wasn't for Jesus?
That's right.
You couldn't have food on your table today if it wasn't for Jesus.
Amen.
Yeah, you wouldn't got it. And God provided money to you to get the food to go get that, right?
Amen.
See, that's what the problem with the world today. Everybody is caught up thinking, well, I worked hard to get this. Well, let me tell you something. You didn't get nothing if it wasn't for Jesus.
Amen.
If he let you get up and go to work, he gave you a blessing.
Amen.
So many people are overlooking the small blessings. They're looking for the big miracles. Amen. They're not looking about the little miracles that's in front of them. Praise
Amen.
God. But you know, one day it's all going to come to a halt. Amen. And a lot of people is going to be sitting around crying and wondering, why me, Lord? Let me tell you something. The Lord is reaching out for somebody today, amen, that needs a touch of God. Amen. Praise God. That they need to reach out and grab a hold of that unchanging hand.
Amen.
So, brothers and sisters, my time is running short. Praise God. I'm going to end this off with a prayer and a song. Amen. Praise God. And the name of the song is, praise God. Where is that? The Long Arm of Love. Praise God.
Amen.
You know, if we can praise God that he has a long arm.
Amen.
No matter how far down the dirt we are, he can always reach up.
Amen.
We can reach up and touch that unchanging hand. Praise
Amen.
God. A lot of people think, well, I can't do that because I'm an alcoholic, or I'm a womanizer, or I'm this and I'm that. If you just turn your life over to Jesus Christ,
Amen.
He'll make a new man, new woman, new creation out of you.
Amen.
The old thing's gone away, and all things be made new.
Amen.
Praise God. So, brothers and sisters, I'm going to have Brother Steve pray a song of benediction, and then we'll play the song going off.
Father, it's again we thank you, Lord, for this day and the blessings of it, Lord. Father, we ask, Lord, as we walk this walk of life, Lord, that we could walk it closer to you. And Heavenly Father, we ask, Lord, if you'd be with those right there in the radio land, Lord. Be with that drunk or that dope addict, Lord, that they would just reach up to you. You'd reach down to them, Lord, and just help them, Lord, to be a new creature in you. Heavenly Father, we're thankful for your word that guides us day by day. And Heavenly Father, help us, Lord, to take it one day at a time, Lord. We ask these things in the sweet name of Jesus Christ, our only Son. Amen and amen.
Amen. You heard it from the man of God, from the House of Prayer Radio Ministries. And enjoy this song. Praise God, the long arm of love. Amen. From Brother Irvin Taylor. Like I said, hit him up. Contact him. I understand he gives the CDs free. Amen. Praise God. And I'm still waiting on mine, Brother Irvin. Amen. I'm using these MP3s, but you know, ain't nothing better than having it in your hand. Amen. Praise God. So, brothers and sisters, enjoy this song. And let God be God in your life. Keep us in prayer. We'll keep you in prayer. We need the prayers. You need to practice.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Love all of you. God bless.
The thing that you've done. Lord.